Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to solve equation. Find all real solutions for x plus 3 to the 4th plus x plus 1 to the 4th equal 82. How to solve this equation? I'm going to start off by defining a new variable y. Okay, so we are going to let y equal the middle point of x plus 1 and x plus 3, which is x plus 2. Or you just do the average of x plus 3 and x plus 1. That's just x plus 2. So then I'm going to use the substitution to rewrite this equation. So then just use x minus 2, replace x here and here, then simplify. Then we have the following equation. So that's just y plus 1 to the 4th plus y minus 1 to the 4th, then equal 82. So then I'm going to expand these two terms. But in order to expand these two terms, I'm going to use binomial theorem. So here's a formula. It's just a plus b to the 4th. Then equal a to the 4th plus 4a to the 3rd b plus 6a squared b squared plus 4ab to the 3rd plus b to the 4th. If here's a minus, if here we have a minus b to the 4th, so then this one minus, then everything else are the same. Okay, so then I'm going to use these two formulas to expand these two terms. Okay, so then a is like y, then b is like 1. Okay, so let's expand y plus 1 to the 4th first. Okay, from here, so then continue to here. So then we have y to the 4th, this one, then 4y to the 3rd, then plus 6y squared plus 4y, then plus 1. That's for the first term. Then plus, expand the second one. Then plus y to the 4th. Then here, that's a minus. Minus 4y to the 3rd. Then plus 6y squared. Then minus. Minus 4y. Then plus 1. Then equal 82. Then simplify the left-hand side. Okay, so adding these two together, then we continue. Adding these two together, that's 2y to the 4th. So then these two cancel out. See? This one, that one, positive, negative, cancel out. So then these two adding together, that's 12y squared. Then these two cancel out. Positive, negative, cancel out. Then here, adding together, that's 2. Then equal 82. Because every term is even, so then to both sides divided by 2. Then simplify. Then we have here, so then we have y to the 4th. Then here, 6y squared. This here equal 40. So the reason at the beginning we set a new variable, just so some terms can cancel out. So here, right now, we have an equation, just three terms. Otherwise, so we'll have the equation with five terms. So it will be harder to solve. Okay, so that's the reason why we set a new variable at the beginning. So now I'm going to solve this equation. So we have a y squared, we have three terms, we have y to the 4th. So then if I rewrite this term, you can tell that's a quadratic equation. See here? So if I rewrite this one as a y square, then square, so then you can tell, so this is an equation in y square. Okay, this quadratic equation in y square. So then we can use a quadratic formula or use a factoring to solve this equation. Okay, I'm going to try factoring. Okay, so then we have here, so do the factoring, so I will have y square plus 10, then y squared minus 4 equal 0. Okay, so then let's see. So let's see the first factor. Okay, so the one factor times another one equals 0. Let's see the first factor. Okay, so then let's see the first factor. That's y squared plus 10. Because minimum value for y squared is always bigger than or equal to 0. Okay, so minimum value is 0. So y squared plus 10 is always bigger than 0. Okay, so this whole thing is bigger than 0. So that's why, so they cannot be 0. So that means only way to be 0, just y squared minus 4 equals 0. Okay, so that means this part equals 0. So that's why we have y squared minus 4 equals 0. Then solve this equation. Just both sides. Move forward to the other side. Then take a square root. So then we have so y equal positive negative 2. But we want to get a solution for x. Okay, we want to get a solution for x. So then remember at the beginning we set a y equal x plus 2. So then we want to get a solution for x. So from here we have x equal y minus 2. So then we have solution for y, positive negative 2. Plug in here. So then we have positive negative 2 minus 2. So then we have the solution for x. So then here is positive 2, negative 2, that's 0. Negative 2, negative 2, that's negative 4. So that's why 0 and the negative 4, they are the solution of the equation. Thanks for watching. I'll see you with another video. Take care.